who is putting country before party, somebody who has somehow lost their voice, but will refine enough to give it to you today. Would you please welcome to the stage, Anna Soubry.
Hello. Thank you very much indeed for coming along today. And as you can hear, I have a very sore throat, but I will always be a strong voice for the 48%. I'm going to rehearse all the arguments that have been made. I just want to say a few things. First thing to say is this. All of us here gathered today, can I just say, I'm not the only Tory in Parliament Square. I'm loving these guys over here. Thank you so much, guys. But seriously, we all take the view that our country made a terrible mistake 2 years ago. But there's something quite remarkable about the 48% of people who voted Remain. We accepted the result. Overwhelmingly, we accepted the result. This is not a rerun of the EU referendum debate. This is about where we are now. And I believe it's now no longer about 48%. It's about the majority of people in this country, whether they voted Leave or Remain, who are waking up and looking at Brexit reality, and they are very, very worried, and rightly so. As you know, and as they know, they were tricked and conned. It's not just the money on the bus that will never materialise. It's also the fact, and it is a fact, that people now understand we are in grave danger of doing real harm to our economy. It's not just Airbus, not just BMW. It's all the businesses, big, small, all sectors, that in private say how worried they are, but they can't say it yet in public. I'm going to come on to why that is in just a minute. It's also about Northern Ireland. And you'll remember the very wise words of Caroline Lucas when she talked about the real threat to peace now in Northern Ireland. It's about security. It's about Erasmus. It's about all those things that you made the arguments for, and now people are understanding why you made those arguments, and frankly, why you were right. So it's not the 48%, it's now the majority of people in our country coming together, demanding that we have a say about this final deal, because we care not just about our futures, but the future of our children and our grandchildren. And we have a right to have a say. But it's also about this. Each and every one of you here, and those that will see all of this and read about it, we are all part now of what I believe is a bigger and very important movement. I don't know about you, but I don't think this great country of ours is any better than we were before the EU referendum. Those deep divisions have been exposed, and nobody, no leader, has sought to heal the terrible wounds inflicted by this EU referendum. And my good friend David Lammy quite rightly talked about those divisions. I want a fairer, kinder, brilliant Britain. A brilliant one as well, but one that is more tolerant. A country that doesn't look at the colour of your skin, doesn't care whether you're wearing a cross on your throat or you're wearing a hijab or a turban, but sees you as the person that you are, a human being. This is a country we must now build. These are the divisions we must now heal. And it is emotional, but I want us to put love back into the heart of this great country of ours. So, You've heard some brilliant speeches, and I think we should congratulate all the brilliant speakers. You have been brilliant for coming along today, and we thank you for your support and all that you have given today. It's been great. It's a lovely day, but I'm afraid I've got some bad news now. The hard work starts, guys. Look, we all get it, but we've got to convince an awful lot of people in our country. And this is a big, hard job. It means you're going to have to talk to your friends, your neighbours, your family, anybody you work with, anybody you know. Yes, it's right, sign the petition, but get other people to sign the petition as well. Make the case, make the argument. We have to build a huge movement. And we build that movement because we have to convince my 649 colleagues that are normally over there in that fine building that they have to give the people a people's vote on the deal. So, thank you again. Thank you for all that you do. And promise me and everybody else that, like us, you will join us in doing that work and making sure that everybody does have a say on the deal, deal or no deal, and that the people have a people's vote on what happens next. Thank you so much for all you do.